Michelle here, and welcome to the M Blog channel. I post every Wednesday and Sunday about career, college, growth, and self-growth. So you'll see a little bit of everything in this channel, and it's really to support us in our successes in the future. So I'm all about that. If you're into that, please click that subscribe button and alert button so you know when these videos are up, as well as connect with me on Instagram, where we get more personal and you can ask me any questions through my messaging. That's kind of where I like to respond the most. I also have a Snapchat, so go ahead and check all of that out. But nonetheless, in this video, I'll be sharing with you guys everything that you need to know for your resume. I've had experience writing my resume early on. I had internships that were really strong internships. I think I had a lot of strong internships because of my resume. And I do feel like your resume sends a vibe to the recruiter. And I'm going to be sharing with you the different ways that that happens. I'll also be sharing three resumes, one with no degree, another one with minimal experiences and internship-based experiences, resumes, and showing you how you can format that on your resume. And nonetheless, let's get started with the video. All right, we're going to start with organization. This will include the organization of the subtitles in your resume, which would be education, skills, certifications, languages, and any additional items that you're considering and putting on your resume. That's what we're going to be talking about. And the way that you want to organize these items is based off of two things: the thing that you've most recently done and whichever one is the most impressive. So what I'm talking about when being most impressive, it would be like any degree that you've gotten or any certifications that you've gotten. So that's kind of the organization that I'm talking about. The organization of your resume for these items is going to be based on the position that you're in currently. So if you don't have a degree, for instance, you're not going to want to put languages first. You're not going to want to put your skill set first, but instead you might have a certification that is really admirable. Maybe you have completed an SEO certification through Google. So you're going to want to put that first instead. I've provided an example here.
All right, guys, this is the first resume for someone who doesn't have a degree. It is a mock-up resume, and you will see that I begin this by adding certifications first, skills, and experience. So the way that you do set up your resume will really affect the tone that you're presenting out to the employer. You really want to make sure that the first thing they see is something credible, something that they can rely on, and something to have like certifications, especially if you don't have that degree, will give you an edge up. The fact that you're adding it in the beginning is telling them a story. So you're taking them through the certifications that you have. The skills are next, as you can see that you have acquired through that certification, also from your experiences. So when you scroll down, or I scroll down, you're going to see that I have added experiences. You don't have to have many. Two is totally okay. One is totally okay. But you want to add a bullet point. Something that I failed to do here is I didn't add an extra bullet point. So for every one that you have, you want to add another one. That's just the way that I do it. I've heard a lot of people do it the same way, but that's something that I failed to do here. At the bottom, you're going to see I added activities. So when you don't have a degree, it's really good to have not just your experiences, but on top of that, on top of your work life, what are you doing? Do you have a website? Do you do some community service? You're going to want that to, you want to add that to your resume, since this is a non-degree resume. You're going to have a little bit more on your resume to have that competitive edge, especially also if you're struggling with finding networking. So this is the way I would structure if you don't have a degree: certification, skills, experience, and then activities.
So I hope that that was very helpful for someone who doesn't have a degree. The next thing that we're going to talk about is someone who has a degree but not many experiences, as well as someone who has a degree and also has some internships under the belt mostly. So this is kind of the layout that you want to pay attention to.
So this next resume is for the person who has a degree and also has some internships under their belt. This is exactly how I make my resume. So here's a quick look into how I make my resume. I start off with my education, and I put my GPA there. Relevant courses is another thing I add. GPA is only recommended if it's strong, so don't add it if you feel like it's on the weaker end. So then following that, I have certifications, and then next to that is experience and activities. So for the beginning part where you show your education, again, you're seeing a story saying if you're currently doing it now, or this is the highest thing that you've accomplished in your life. And then certifications, again, it's saying what you are certified in aside from your education, and then saying a story of where you've worked, what opportunities you've had. So that's kind of what follows the certification part, is your experiences. So that's what follows the certification part, is going to be your experiences, because it's going to be backing up those certifications, that education. And you just put, again, those bullet points, the date and activities, something you've added on top of that, which would be creating a website, community service, etc. It's really just emphasizing the beginning portion of how you're beginning the story, how you're beginning to introduce yourself. So the next resume is going to be for the person who has a degree but didn't get any experiences with internships. So you have other types of experiences, which could be you were a part of a club, or you have created your own website, but beyond that, you don't have much. So again, you're going to put your degree. It's the highest thing you're accomplishing right now or have accomplished. And then the next thing would be scholarships. If you haven't done certifications, you may have gotten scholarships because of your GPA. Again, GPA is one of those things that you only want to add if it's a notable accomplishment alongside your relevant courses. You're saying a story. What have you done during your time there? Next is skills. When you were at the university, what skills did you acquire? What did you learn in those classes? And then again, you haven't acquired any experiences. This happens a lot. So what activities have you been a part of? Were you making a website? Were you learning how to create content? What club were you a part of when you were in college? What hobbies did you partake in? So that's going to be the next thing, especially because you want to emphasize where your time has been. It's an explanation of where you've, what you've been doing, why you did it, and just building it up for the person reading it. And then following that, maybe you have an experience as a sales associate. So this at the end, maybe it is so at the end because it is not relevant to the job that you're going to be applying for. If you're going to be like a marketer, maybe sales associate isn't something that is tied to the job. The job that we're talking about is a career job, something a little bit higher up, and it really cannot be related to what you're doing. So you're going to want to add that to the end. But what really we want to focus on is, again, the education, the scholarships, the skills, and any relevant information with the activities that you have taken during that time are going to be in the middle of it, just explaining more of that story and ending it with just side experiences, which is a completely normal thing to do in your time in college, to have kind of like a sales associate job. But it is something that I would have at the end, because what we want to have people focus on is the scholarships, the skills, and the education to make it sound credible.
As you can tell, this is very general, and you might actually organize it a little bit differently based on your situation. But for the most part, this will give you a good sense about how organization tells a story about you, as well as that it depends on two factors, on the order of the events that things have happened in your life, as well as the highest achieving thing that you've accomplished. So just take a look at that when you're building out your resume and the structure of it. Now we're going to move on to the design of your resume. There's many ways that this can go about, but basically the design is going to say, again, a lot about you to the recruiter. My resume is a lot like the ones I showed you early on. It's only black and white, so I feel like it steers more on the professional route. But if you choose to add color and make it more of a design, it's going to be more creative, and it might speak more in the creative aspect of your life. I honestly am going to share personal experience. I think that a lot of the jobs that I got were more professional because my resume was more professional. I tried getting an event management internship, and I don't think I got it because my resume wasn't as creative. It might have been one of the factors, I don't know entirely, but I do feel like the way that you structure your resume with the design portion says a lot about you. So that's kind of what the first thing I want to focus on. But there is some things that are a rule of thumb, which is keep it to just one page, especially if you have less than 6 years of experience, half inch margins all the way around, and your font should be no less than 10, because people need to read this. They don't want to be like, hey, with little like magnifying glass, like, hey, what is that say? You don't want that. That's the kind of the thing for a resume and design. Just make sure that you're not giving the recruiter a hard time by making the fonts too small, and also just not compacting the resume with too much, because that's just going to give them a pain. All right, guys, so just stick to that. Make sure that you have nothing misspelled and everything is accurate, and you should be good to go. And that's everything that you need to know about resume building. If you have any more questions, please make sure to add them down below, and I'll make sure to check them out. Again, subscribe if you enjoyed the video and give it a like, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!